الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد, we have the class of tafsir from سورة المائدة. إن شاء الله تعالى verse 17, Surah Al-Ma'idah, Surah 5, Al-Ma'idah, verse 17. Allah Azza wa Jalla said, لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْمَسِيحُ بْنُ مَرْيَمُ قُلْ فَمَنْ يَمْلِكُ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْئًا إِنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يُهْلِكَ الْمَسِيحَ بْنَ مَرْيَمَ وَأُمَّهُ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ جَمِيعًا وَلِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ جَزَاكَ اللَّهُ خَيْرًا وللله ملك السماوات والأرض وما بينهما يخلق ما يشاء والله على كل شيء قدير. لقد كفر الذين قالوا إن الله هو المسيح ابن مريم قل فمن يملك من الله شيئا إن أراد أن يهلك المسيح ابن مريم وأمه ومن في الأرض جميعا ولله ملك السماوات والأرض وما بينهما يخلق ما يشاء والله على كل شيء قدير. قال الإمام الشيخ عبد الرحمن السعدي رحمه الله في قول الله عز وجل, لقد كفر الذين قالوا إن الله هو المسيح ابن مريم, الآية لما ذكر تعالى أخذ الميثاق على أهل الكتابين وأنهم لم يقوموا به بل نقضوه, ذكر أقوالهم الشنيعة, فذكر قول النصارى القول الذي ما قاله أحد غيرهم بأن الله هو المسيح ابن مريم, ووجه شبهتهم أنه ولد من غير أب, فاعتقدوا فيه هذا الاعتقاد الباطل, مع أن حواء نظيره خلقت بلا أم, وآدم أولى منه خلق بلا أب ولا أم, فهل ادعوا فيهما الإلهية كما ادعوها في المسيح؟ فدل على أن قولهم اتباع هوى من غير برهان ولا شبهة, فرد الله عليهم بأدلة عقلية واضحة فقال, قل فمن يملك من الله شيئا إن أراد أن يهلك المسيح ابن مريم وأمه ومن في الأرض جميعا. فإذا كان المذكورون لم تناع عندهم يمنعهم لو أراد الله أن يهلكهم ولا قدرة لهم على ذلك, دل على بطلان إلهية من لا يمتنع من الإهلاك ولا في قوته شيء من الفكاك. ومن الأدلة أن لله وحده ملك السماوات والأرض يتصرف فيهم بحكمه الكوني والشرعي والجزائي. قال المؤلف رحمه الله, من الأدلة أن لله وحده ملك السماوات والأرض يتصرف فيهم بحكمه الكوني والشرعي والجزائي, وهم مملوكون مدبرون, فهل يليق أن يكون المملوك العبد الفقير إلها معبودا غنيا من كل وجه؟ هذا من أعظم المحال. ولا وجه لاستغرابهم لخلق المسيح عيسى بن مريم من غير أب, فإن الله يخلق ما يشاء, إن شاء من أب وأم كسائر بني آدم, وإن شاء من أب بلا أم كحواء, وإن شاء من أم بلا أب كعيسى, وإن شاء من غير أب ولا أم كآدم. فنوع خليقته تعالى بمشيئته النافذة التي لا يستعصي عليها شيء, ولهذا قال, والله على كل شيء قدير. ومن مقالات اليهود, in this ayah verse 17 المائدة, الله عز وجل said, لقد كفر الذين قالوا إن الله هو المسيح ابن مريم. Surely they disbelieve those who say that Allah is the Messiah, son of Maryam, Mary. Say, O the Messenger of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who then has the least power against Allah if he were to destroy the Messiah, son of Maryam, his mother, all those who are on the earth together. And to Allah belongs the dominion of the heaven and the earth, and all that is between them. He creates what he wills, and Allah is able to do all things. In this ayah, Allah Azza wa Jalla mentioned the ruling of those who claim, of those who say that Messiah, the son of Maryam, Isa, is a god. What is their ruling? Their ruling is that they are kafaru, they disbelieve. This is the rule of Allah Azza wa Jal. They are not believers, they are disbelievers. Because Allah said, kafaru. Laqad, harfu tahqiq, surely, verily, indeed. Kafara alladhina qalu. They disbelieve those who say, inna Allah wal Masih ibn Maryam. Allah is the Messiah, son of Maryam. Subhanallah. So they disbelieve. It's amazing today you have someone who says he's a Muslim. He's imam of a masjid. He memorized all Quran. He memorized this ayah. He's Arabic speaker. With all that he says, that you can't say that the Christian are disbelievers. Say, don't say it. What should I say? Say they are the people of the book. Yes, they are the people of the book, but at the same time, kafaru, they disbelieve. Allah said that. They say, no, don't say it. This is how some people who recite Quran are far from the Quran. Hasbunallah wa ni'mal wakil. They have what they call a unity of religions. Wuhdat al-adiyan. Unity of religions. They have what they call Abrahamic faith. They say the Jewish and to Prophet Ibrahim. The Christian to Prophet Ibrahim. Muslims, Prophet Ibrahim. So all of it is the same. Some of them publish the Quran and the Bible in one book. Some of them they build the church, the masjid, the church, and the place of the Yahud. It's very widespread. Saying all this is equal. You follow the Christian, you Christian, or you Jewish, you Muslim, doesn't matter. That's what they say. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in this ayah, in the case of the Christian, kafaru, they disbelief. I remember one time, one of those, they corrupted and have this ideology, layman, I talked to him in the masjid, and he said, don't say they're disbelievers. You don't say Christians, you are disbelievers. I said, Allah said that. Let me show you. I had the noble Quran, I show him. This ayah. لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ ثَالِثُ ثَلَاثَ. They disbelieve those who say Allah is one of three. The Trinity. He said, no, no. My imam say, you can't say disbelief. He said, but Allah says this. It's not me who wrote down. That was the last time I see him. He got mad at me. He left. So this is where some people are. وَلَا حَوْلَ وَلَا قُوَّةِ إِلَّا بِاللَّهِ لَقَدْ كَفَرَ الَّذِينَ قَالُوا. Surely they disbelieve those who say, إِنَّ اللَّهُ وَالْمَسِيحُونُ مَرْيَمْ. Allah is the Messiah, son of Maryam, son of Mary. That's what they claim. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refute them with intellectual proof. دليل عقلي. Intellectual proof. That everyone with sound mind, he can understand. That why Isa is not ilah. Why Isa, the son of Maryam, why he is not ilah, why he is not a god. The intellectual proof Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used so much in the book, the intellectual proof. So the person, even who doesn't believe Quran, he has another way to know the Quran to be truth. It's by sound intellect. Being questioned. Like the atheists. أَمْ خُلِقُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ أَمْ هُمُ الْخَالِقُونَ Did they just happen? Nobody created them? Or they create themselves? Anyone who uses his mind, he tells you. He says, no, he didn't create himself. It's impossible, intellectually, to create himself. How can he create himself? He was not existing. Before he came into existence, he was not existing. While he's not existing, how can he make into existence? And he's not even existing. Intellectual. Okay, what left is that it just happened. Nobody created. That's intellectually wrong. Because the way the human is made is impossible to be just happen. Because it's organized. It's a balance. And people with aql, intellect, they differentiate between what's just happened and what was made with knowledge. Rather, the more something is very sophisticated, very complicated, very organized, the more it needs more knowledge. It's very basic. When any building who is built in this county, they send somebody from the county. He looked the building. He looked. He was not there when it was being built. He checked everything. He sometimes revoked the license of the one who built it. And sometimes they hire him in the county itself. They say, you did a great job. How they know? Through what they see. They know what this needs of knowledge. Likewise, they look the engine of the car. They say, this company who made it, he did a great job. Because they see it. Don't you, when you see somebody in front of you, can't you judge that he's short, that he's tall? Can you do that? Yes. By what? By intellect. By the sound intellect. Which one is bigger, me talking to you brothers, or this building? The building. How we know that? By intellect. So Allah questioned them. Did they create by themselves? The answer is no. Because it's contradiction, intellectually. Are they just happen? Do they look like something just happened? Should have been upside down. Wouldn't be organized. Wouldn't be. So now nothing left but that they have been created. Then worship that creator. This is intellectual proof. As for the other world, as for the Christian here, Allah also subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned intellectual proof. Wages. Allah said, قُلْ فَمَنْ يَمْلِكُ مِنَ اللَّهِ شَيْئًا إِنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يُهْلِكَ الْمَسِيحَ ابْنَ مَرْيَمَ وَأُمَّهُ Say, O the Messenger of Muhammad, who then has the least power against Allah if Allah were to destroy the Messiah, the son of Maryam, his mother, and all those who are on the earth together? Christian, ask them today. Whether you say Jesus is a God or a son of God, can God, they call Father, subhanAllah, can he destroy Jesus? They say yes. His mother, yes. Everything on earth, yes. You believe that, yes. So if Isa cannot resist himself from destruction, nor his mother, nor anyone on earth, that proof is that they are not what? They are not gods. They don't have a description of God. God should be perfect. Should be all-powerful. Not someone who can be destroyed. In the same surah, Allah subhanahu wa kareem in his Quran, he proved that they wrong in many ayat. In every ayah, there's a kisra benefit. From another ayah in the same surah, Allah said, مَا الْمَسِيحُ ابْنُ مَرْيَمْ إِلَّا رَسُولُ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ وَأُمُّهُ صِدِّيقَةٌ كَانَ يَأْكُلَانِ طَعَامٌ Allah mentioned that Isa is the son of Maryam. By him being son of somebody is a proof he's not God. By being son of someone, he's not God for the one who is his son. Isa is not a God for his mother. She gave him birth. that anyone with doesn't make sense. The mother was created by her son, by her daughter. Why is she mother then? Doesn't have any meaning. Mother has to be before the son. Has to be before the... This is the history. This is the apparent thing. This is the aql. To make the opposite. The son create the mother. It's not in any language. It's not in any culture. It's not in any. So also Allah said, قَدْ خَلَدْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُولِ. Means Isa, there were people who used to live before him. They know it. Ibrahim was before him, Musa before him. So someone who somebody came before him, how can he be God of the one who came before him? Allah said also, كَانَ يَأْكُلَانِ الطَّعَامِ. Isa and Maryam, they used to eat food. كَانَ يَأْكُلَانِ الطَّعَامِ. What does that mean? What that has to do proving that Isa is not God, that he used to eat food. Yes? He used bathroom. This is deficiency. This is not a description, subhanAllah, of a God free from all imperfections. This is a deficiency. Yes? How God can be born? Who is the creator of the heaven and the earth? Because the creator of the heaven and the earth didn't born in 2,000 years. كَانَ يَأْكُلَانَ الطَّعَامِ. He used to eat food. What it means also, he used to eat food, he was in need of the food. This is not a description of God to be in need of something. Even they tell you, God is perfect, need nobody. Okay, how about Isa eating food? Why he eating? He in need of it. Okay, he's not a God. So, in this ayah, Sheikh Sa'd, what he said, نعم فرد الله عليهم بأدلة عقلية واضحة. Allah refused them with a clear intellectual proofs. فقال and said, قل فما يملك من الله شيئا إن أراد أن يهلك المسيح ابن مريم وأمه ومن في الأرض. Who has anything to defend? Who then has the least power against Allah if he were to destroy the Messiah, son of Maryam, and his mother, Isa, Isa's mother, and all those who are on the earth together. Who has? If nobody, if Isa can be destroyed, if Maryam can be destroyed, if everyone on earth can be destroyed, then there is no lordship, there is no godness in there. There is no the description of being God in there. So he's not God. But why they say he's son of God? Allah answered that. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah said, وَلِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. To Allah alone belong everything to the heaven and to the earth. Everything in the heaven and the earth belongs to Allah. What that means? When they say, subhanAllah, Isa is the son of Allah, when they say son of God, Allah answered to them, وَلِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. Everything belongs to Allah, not only Isa. When someone has a son or a daughter, meaning that one, that son, that daughter is specific to that. It's exclusive to him. Is that right? Allah has everything. All are his creation. Why only one? When they say, وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ وَلَدًا, Allah, what he said, سُبْحَانَهُ هُوَ الْغَنِيِّ لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ. Only Isa doesn't belong to Allah. Everything belongs to Allah. Why you, what belongs to Allah, you affirm some, you rejected the other. Everything belongs to Allah. Isa is from those. Why Allah needs son? Why Allah needs daughter? Everything belongs to him. You need son, you need daughter, as a human, as creation, you need to be exclusive to you, to وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلَ الْأَعْلَى. Question, if everyone on earth, any one of us today, all human would have been your children, would you wish to have one of them? Yes? No. Why? Let me have more. If you have 10 good people, why are you having only one? Why you don't have other 9? وَلِلَّهِ الْمَثَلَ الْأَعْلَى. So everything belongs to Allah. As Isa belongs to Allah, everything belongs to the same way. All are ibadullah, creation of Allah. So that's answer. There's no that is only Isa, subhanahu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Isa is son of, no, Allah, everything is the creation of Allah. Isa is slave of Allah. Then likewise, everyone is slave of Allah. ما المسيح ابن مريم ما المسيح لا يستنكف المسيح لا يستنكف المسيح ولا الملائكة المقربون أن يكونوا لا يستنكف المسيح ولا الملائكة المقربون أحسنت بارك الله فيك لا يستنكف المسيح ابن مريم نعم was the eye again لن يستنكف المسيح أن يكون عبدا لله ولا الملائكة المقربون. So عيسى is عبد لله, الملائكة عبد لله, كلهم عباد الله. Why only one belongs to Allah? Everything belongs to him. Then now the question is, what they claim, they say Isa, they say is son of God. Why? Because he didn't have a father. This is the issue. He said, he didn't have a father. Allah answered to them. Allah said, يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ. Allah created who he wills in the same ayah. Allah created who he wills. That's pointing out, that's refutation for how can he be, how is it possible to be a normal human being while Isa doesn't have a father. He had a mother, he should be the son of God. That's Allah refuted them. يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ. And Allah detailed that in another ayah. إِنَّ مَثَلَ عِيسَى عِنْدَ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ آدَمْ. The likeness of Isa with Allah is like Adam. Isa is like son of Maryam, is like Adam. Where is the likeness between Isa and Adam? Rashid, question to you. What's the likeness between Allah said, إِنَّ مَثَلَ عِيسَى عِنْدَ اللَّهِ كَمَثَلِ آدَمْ. The likeness of Isa with Allah, Allah's sight, is like Adam, Allah said. No difference between Adam and Isa. In where? Very good. If they say Isa, since he didn't have a father, which is the truth, he had a mother, they say, then God has to be his father. Jazakallahu khair abdallah. Then here is, how about Adam? Did Adam had a father? They say no. Then are you saying he's son of God? They say no. You contradicted them. If you say Isa is a son of God because he didn't have a human father, then say the same thing with Adam. You are not saying it? Then this is not, you have to leave it that. Simply because Isa was born without father, it's not a proof that Allah has to, subhanahu wa ta'ala, has to be his father. No. Likewise, as the Shaykh mentioned here, you have Hawa. the mother of all human. Who is her father? Adam. Sheikh Saadi said that. Hawa father is Adam. Ab. Because she was created from Adam. Hawa was created from Adam, from the rib of Adam. So in that meaning, he's her father. She was created from him. So now you have Eve, you have Hawa with who? With father and without mother whatsoever. The Christian, they accepted that. Hawa, Eve didn't have a mother. If she didn't have a mother, but you say she had a father, are you saying she's a daughter of God? They say, no, 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 she's not a daughter of God. Then why is a son of God then? Allah answered, he said, يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ. Allah creates what he wills. To prove the power of Allah. Allah created Adam with no mother, no father. He created the rest of human with father, from father, mother. He created Isa with no father, but mother. Hawa with father, no mother. If you say one of them is a son of God or the daughter of God because of he didn't have, then you have to say to the other. If you don't, then you're contradicting. So it is Allah who creates who wills. As Allah said in another ayah, وَاللَّهُ خَلَقَ كُلَّ دَابَّةٍ مِمَّا فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَمْشِي عَلَى بَطْنِهِ سُبْحَانَ اللَّهِ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَمْشِي عَلَى رِجْلَيْنِ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَمْشِي عَلَى أَرْبَعٍ يَخْلُقُ اللَّهُ مَا يَشَاءُ. Allah created all the creature, all moving creature. Allah is who الذي خلق. From that, فَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَمْشِي عَلَى بَطْنِهِ. From what Allah created, يَمْشِي عَلَى بَطْنِهِ. What does that mean? نعم. يمشي على بطن يحبو يمشي yes English reptile بارك الله في محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم reptile walks moves on its stomach crawling on its stomach like a snake amazing a snake go up to the wall very fast to the wall. Is a human being can go to the wall without using hand or anything? You make your hand straight and you go to the wall? No. Ayat Allah Azza wa Jal. Somebody is handcuffed. They tie his hand and his feet. Can he go to the wall, a human being? No. Even though, alhamdulillah, we have bigger chests and bigger body. Small snake go or those. وَمِنْهُمْ يَمْشِي عَلَى رِجْلَيْنِ. From what Allah created, one walks with two legs. وَمِنْهُمْ يَمْشِي عَلَى أَرْبَعٍ. From it, what walks with four. Allah said, يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ. Allah created what he wills. Meaning some of it is different. Maybe eight legs, maybe more. Allahu A'lam, hundreds. It shows the power of Allah Azza wa Jal. It shows that there is Khaliq Murid, الذي يريد, the different creation, different color, different shows that these are intended. It's not just to happen, something intended to be different, different color, different way. فشاهد الشيخ سأل فذكر قول النصارى القول الذي ما قاله أحد غيرهم. Here is a question: why the Christian said also? What led them to say Isa is son of God? هو الغلو. It's exaggeration. Because Isa رضي الله تعالى he born in a miracle way. Then the other all the human around his time. Very miracle way. He did very different things. Talk to the people young. Talk to the dead and come alive. Give his heals, cure, bi-idhnillah, the sick people. Tell people what happened in their houses. What's happening. These are great things. These made them to exaggerate. Oh, it's not normal. Since this is what happened, he shouldn't be a creation. He should be, this is not for anybody, somebody born without mother. Yeah, with other shubahat, he was not killed, even in Islam. He was raised to the heaven. He's the only one raised to the heaven. There has to be something, and those they collected. All these things, it shows specialities, it shows status, but it has nothing to do with being God or being deserving to be worshipped. This is the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Azza wa Jal delivered his messengers in miracle wise. A messenger, Ibrahim had something Prophet Isa was not given. Yes, Prophet Musa, something Prophet Isa was not given. Allah didn't split the ocean for Prophet Isa. It didn't happen. His enemy wanted to kill him. Allah saved him. That's how Prophet Isa was saved. It's his enemy wanted to kill him. No question on that. And instead they killed somebody. Who? Some ulama, they say one of his Sahaba who ransomed himself. Prophet Isa said, my enemy are going to kill me. Who is going to ransom me? And he will be with me in Jannah. One of his Hawariyun said, oh, the Messenger of Allah. So they enter, that's the one they kill. Allah gave the shape, put the shape of Prophet Isa on that companion, on that Hawari. That some one ulama say. Some of them say no. The one who was given the shape, who looked like likeness of Isa, they thought it's Isa, is the one who spy Isa, is the one who tell the enemy where Isa is. But it's Allah who mentioned, وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَا لَهُمْ تَشْبِيهِ. They kill somebody, no question. So they are not upon certainty. Al-Muhim, Isa alayhi salam, saw Prophet Musa, Allah had destroyed Fir'aun and all his army in daylight. And Allah saved all the believers. And they become the authority on earth after that. That miracle, that was not given to Isa alayhi salam. Prophet Nuh, what has been given? All those who were on earth, who disbelieved, all of them were destroyed. None was left. That didn't happen for Isa. Bigger than all those miracles is the miracle of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Al-Quran al-Kareem. Al-Quran al-Kareem is the biggest miracle. It's the biggest Burhan proof. For many ways. One of the ways is all what we have mentioned with Isa, with Ibrahim alayhi salam, with Musa, with Nuh, we don't see it. We believe it. It's truth. Because it comes through sound source. We believe it. But we don't see it. Isa being safe, Fir'aun being destroyed. We don't see that. But Quran, we see it. It's out there. All human, all jinn get together. Produce the like of Quran. Until now it's being waited. The Quran is not the speech of Allah. It's not this. It's not talk as much as you want. Prove that. فَإِنْ لَمْ تَفْعَلُوا وَلَنْ تَفْعَلُوا. If you don't do it, you will never ever do it. فَاتَّقُونَ الْذَنْ فِي رَفَاءَ. So human will have no option but either to believe the Quran or to prove that Quran is not the speech of Allah by bringing a book like it. If they don't bring a book like it, then now they don't believe it, it's very clear. It's the negligence. It's stubborn. It's arrogance. It is there. How many years? 1,400 years passed. Today, mashallah, this last year, technology, whatever you have seen, easy to get together information, to get the information. All these things. But still, Quran is there. You have out there people talking, it's not the book of Allah, Quran is not the book of Allah, Quran. Talk as much as you want. Action is needed. Prove it. With the information which is there, with the knowledge which is there, with the aqidah, with the laws, with many things we don't know. We Muslims even don't know. Only few from the people know it. The ilm of Quran, ilmullah, is the knowledge of Allah. How can you encompass all the knowledge of Allah? Therefore, Muslims, they benefit from Quran every time, every year. There's new knowledge, it's truth, it's fact, it's in the Quran. Quran suffices everybody, the nomad people, civilized people, all the different يعني المهم. So in this ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said وَلِلَّهِ مُلْكُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ and the ownership of the heaven and the earth belongs to Allah وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا all that which is between them يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ Allah creates what he wills. What he, وَاللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ وَاللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ They may say, how Allah create a human being with no father? Allah answer, وَاللَّهُ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٌ Allah is able to do all things. Allah is able to do all things. To Allah is easy to create Isa only from mother. As he create already Hawa, Eve, only from father. As he create Adam, no father, no mother. إِنَّمَا أَمْرُ إِذَا قَالَ إِذَا أَرَادَ أَنْ يَقُولَ لَهُ كُنْ فَيَكُونِ If Allah wishes something to be, he subhanahu wa ta'ala say be. It's going to be. And it's going to be how Allah wants. To be in gradually, to be one time, whatever Allah has to say. He say be, it's going to be. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. So, and this is a refutation for those who claim Isa to be God or to be son of God or to be one of three. All those, iyadan billah, false statements. And what led them again, يا الكتاب لا تغلو في دينكم. Or the people of the book, don't be extreme in your religion. It's exaggeration. Why the Quraysh said the angels are the daughters of Allah, subhanallah wa bihamdi. Why the Quraysh, they said that? It's because of the status of angels. They know it. Angels are special. So they say it has to be a daughter of subhanallah. Why the Jewish, a group of the Jewish said Uzair is the son of God. وَقَالَتِ الْيَهُودِ عُزَيْرٌ ابْنُ اللَّهِ وَقَالَتِ النَّصَارَى الْمَسِيحُ ابْنُ اللَّهِ ذَلِكَ قَوْلُهُمْ بِأَفْوَاهِهِمْ يُضَاهِئُونَ قَوْلَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِنْ قَبْلُ They only saying what those before them said. Those Christians who today here, they say Trinity. They say Jesus is God. Jesus is Son of God. Where they brought this from? A group of them who were before them. If you go back to the history, you end up time, this was not existing. The time of Prophet Isa, this was not existing. Now don't you see some Muslims who bow down, who make sujood for the Prophet ﷺ? Do those exist? Yes. People who make ruku' towards the grave of Prophet ﷺ. Wallahi al-Azim. People who ask the Messenger ﷺ, children, ask health, ask safety, protection. These are so many people. But if you go back to the history, you don't find that at the life of the Prophet. So whoever doing that, is they doing what those before them, they did it. They are not upon ilm. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Azza wa Jal. So this is what Sheikh Sa'di said. يَخْلُقُ مَا يَشَاءُ إِنْ شَاءَ مِنْ أَبٍ وَأُمْ Allah creates what he wills, if he wants, from father and mother. The Shaykh said, كَسَائِرْ بَنِي آدَمْ like the, as the case of the rest of the son of Adam. وَإِنْ شَاءَ مِنْ أَبٍ بِلَا أُمْ كَحَوَى And if Allah wants, he creates someone من أبٍ from father بِلَا أُمٍ without mother. كَحَوَى like حَوَى Eve. وَإِنْ شَاءَ And by the way, there is Sahih al-Bukhari hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari that حَوَى the name of our mother حَوَى That's in Sahih al-Bukhari. Okay. وَإِنْ شَاءَ مِنْ أُمٍ بِلَا أَبْ وَإِنْ شَاءَ مِنْ أُمٍ بِلَا أَبْ And if Allah wants to create someone from mother, no father, كَعِيسَى, the Shaykh said, Isa. وَإِنْ شَاءَ مِنْ غَيْرِ أَبٍ وَلَا أُمٍ If Allah wants to create someone without father, without mother, كَآدَم, as Adam. So now if the Christians, they say, Isa is son of God because he didn't have a father, a human father, then the answer is, how about Adam? He didn't have a human father. You say he's son of God. You say no, you have to start from. If they say he's son of God, why? Because he has some miracles. He has something no other prophet had it. Likewise, there are other prophets he had, they had something, Isa never had it. If they say, the last thing they say, it's in the Bible, prove the Bible to be the book of Allah. Authenticate the Bible. If you don't prove that, then you have no proof. This is no proof, this is no proof, this is no proof. Get back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and stop the shirk. In the next ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya Ahlal, Allah Azza wa Jalla said subhanahu wa ta'ala, وقالت اليهود والنصارى نحن أبناء الله وأحباؤه قل فلما يعذبكم بذنوبكم بل أنتم بشر ممن خلق يغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء ولله ملك السماوات والأرض وما بينهما وإليه المصير. قال الإمام الشيخ عبد الرحمن السعدي رحمه الله في هذه الآية فدل على أن قولهم قال ومن مقالات اليهود والنصارى أن كل منهما ادعى دعوة باطلة يزكون بها أنفسهم بأن قال كل منهما نحن أبناء الله وأحباؤه. والابن في لغتهم هو الحبيب ولم يريدوا البنوة الحقيقية فإن هذا ليس من مذهبهم إلا مذهب النصارى في المسيح. قال الله ردا عليهم حيث دعوا بلا برهان قل فلما يعذبكم بذنوبكم فلو كنتم أحبابه ما عذبكم لكون الله لا يحب إلا من قام بمراضيه قل فلما يعذبكم بذنوبكم فلما كنتم فلو كنتم أحبابه ما عذبكم بل أنتم بشر ممن خلق تجري عليكم أحكام العدل والفضل تجري عليكم أحكام العدل والفضل يغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء إذا أتوا بأسباب المغفرة أو أسباب العذاب. ولله ملك السماوات والأرض وما بينهما وإليه المصير أي فأي شيء خصكم بهذه الفضيلة وأنتم من جملة المماليك ومن جملة من يرجع إلى الله في الدار الآخرة فيجازيكم بأعمالكم. In this ayah verse 18 الله عز وجل said وقالت اليهود والنصارى نحن أبناء الله وحباه. And both the Jewish and the Christian say we are Abna'ullah. Abna'ullah. Here the translator said, we are the children of Allah. And Sheikh Sa'di said, Abna' here means the beloved ones. Because they didn't claim to be the children of Allah. Only Christians claim that for Isa. And the Jewish and the Christians say we are the children of Allah and his loved ones. وَأَحِبَّاءُ قُلْ فَلِمَ يُعَذِّبْكُمْ بِذُنُوبِكُمْ. Say, why then does he, Allah, punish you for your sins? بَلْ أَنْتُمْ بَشَرٌ. Nay, you are but human beings. Of those he has created, مِمَّنْ خَلَقْ. يغفر لمن يشاء. Allah forgives whom he wills. ويعذب من يشاء. And he punishes whom he wills. ولله ملك السماوات والأرض. And to Allah belongs the dominion of the heavens and the earth. وإليه المصير. And to him alone. وما بينهما. And all that's between them. وإليه المصير. And to him is the return of all. In this ayah, Allah mentioned that the Jewish and Christians said, نحن أبناء الله. As the Sheikh here said, we the children of Allah. Do the Christians and the Jewish of our time, do they have this belief that they are the children of God? Or they only say that for Isa, for instance, Christian? Or they say everybody? Only for Isa. Yes. They don't say they are children of God. They say, very good. So they say they are the children of God. Because I ask them, a group they call, they say they are Jehovah's Witness. And they say they don't believe Jesus being Son of God. That's the way they say it. I say, you don't believe that Jesus is Son of God? Yes. What about in the Bible? That's the words in the written. They say that doesn't mean son. It has everybody. They say we all are children of God. They say we all. It's not only Isa. We all son of God, they say. So there's two groups. One group who say only Isa. The Orthodox. Jesus is a God. Okay. Al-Muhim. So they said, whether it is they say we are the children of God, as the literally this, or the Sheikh Sa'di said, here they don't mean we are the children of God. They mean we are beloved ones to God. Because he said they don't believe the Christian, the Jewish, to be son of God, and they don't believe the Christian, except they only believe for Isa. They say Isa is son of God. Sheikh Sa'di said that. So there may be different madahib. Yes. Which is a lie, which is a lie. They steal every day. How they say Jesus died for them and so they don't have sin. And they kill one another every day. That's not sin? How many Christians steal people's property? That's not a sin? What do they mean? Perhaps why Isa is suffering because of somebody's sin? That's not from the adl of Allah Azza wa Jal. وَلَا تَزِرُ وَازِرَةٌ وِزْرَ أُخْرَى. Jesus, they say, was crucified because of our sin. How are those who came before Isa? They already left with their sin? Or what? Why Allah is punishing someone because of the sin of another one? Somebody free, somebody innocent, Allah is punishing because of somebody who is. This is not the justice of Allah. All that is to justify their corrupted belief. Try everything they can see. Tayyib. So they said, Allah, abna'ullahi wa hibba'uhu. They say we are the children of Allah and His beloved ones. And this is one of the ways the people of the book, those two deviated, this is one of their bad characters, which is that they praise themselves. They praise themselves. They said in another ayah, وَقَالُوا لَنْ يَدْخُلَ الْجَنَّةَ إِلَّا مَنْ كَانَ هُودًا أَوْ نَصَارًا. It's impossible somebody to enter Jannah except if he's Jewish. The Jewish said that. And the Christians, nobody will enter Jannah unless he is Christian. Say that, they say that, right? They say, believe Jesus and then you're saved. If you don't believe, you are not saved. Okay. So the Christians, they say, they enter in Jannah. Only them. The Jews, they say, only them. Okay. That's what they claim. This is praising. Somebody praising himself. In Islam, you don't praise yourself. فَلَا تُزَكُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ فَلَا تُزَكُوا. Don't praise yourself. هُوَ أَعْلَمُ بِمَنِ اتَّقَى. It's only Allah who knows the most who have taqwa. To praise yourself, you have to have sound heart. You have to have pure heart. You have to have righteousness in your heart. How you say that about yourself? People don't know that. Somebody, he may be a disbeliever. And the people may not know. Rather, even Messenger Hussein didn't know some of the disbelievers. If Messenger Hussein couldn't know a disbeliever, enemy of Allah, who else know? Nobody. From the human. So when you praise yourself, how the people can know you're telling the truth? because they don't know. Therefore, don't praise yourself. Yet it's to them to judge what they see. Your action, your statement, they judge that. They see you doing good, they say good about you. They see you doing bad, they say bad about you. Because what they see, what they hear. But in reality, Allahu A'lam, the reality of this creation. Because to judge somebody, being good or bad, it needs two things. His intentions, his heart, and his action. Somebody may do bad thing, seeming to you bad, but his heart may be sound. Therefore, Allah doesn't even punish. Because the person was honest. He didn't know that. He was enforced. He mistaken. Even somebody said, oh Allah, subhanallah. Even somebody, by he mistake. He said, oh Allah, you are my slave, I am your Lord. Did Allah punish him? No, Allah accepted his tawbah. Because he said by mistake. So somebody may say bad something wrong, and he still be giving excuse. Because his heart is sound. And someone may say good thing, very right thing. But because his heart is corrupted, it will not be accepted. إِذَا جَاءَكَ الْمُنَافِقُونَ قَالُوا نَشْهَدُ إِنَّكَ لَرَسُولُ. Munafiqeen, they come to the Prophet, they bear witness, they testify that you, the Messenger of Allah, or Messenger Muhammad. Well, Allah said, وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ إِنَّهُمْ لَكَاذِبُونَ. Allah knows that they lie. وَاللَّهُ يَشْهَدُ إِنَّهُمْ لَكَاذِبُونَ. They don't believe that. So somebody to be good, his inner heart, his inward and his outward has to be sound both. And it's only Allah who watches the secrets. What's in the braces, what's in the heart, what person that's in his secret life. That's the reality. So the Jewish, the Christian, they praise themselves. They said, نحن أبناء الله وحباؤه. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala questioned them. قُلْ فَلِمَا يُعَذِّبْكُمْ بِذُنُوبِكُمْ. Say, why then does he punish you for your sin? If you are beloved ones to Allah, why are you suffering? Why are you being punished? How many times Allah punish you? In another ayah, إِنْ زَعَمْتُمْ أَنَّكُمْ أَوْلِيَاءُ لِلَّهِ مِنْ دُونِ النَّاسِ فَتَمَنَّوا الْمَوْتِ إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. If you claim that you are the friends of Allah beside Allah, you're close to Allah than any other one, Allah love you, then expect, wish to die. إِنْ كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. If telling the truth, وَلَا يَتَمَنَّوْنَهُ أَبَدًا. They never wish to die. يَوَدُّ أَحَدُهُمْ لَوْ يُعَمَّرُ أَلْفَ سَنَةٍ. One of them wished if he would have been, he would have alive for how many years? 1,000 years. If you are a willy of Allah, you're righteous, you believe that, then hasten to death. Go to your Lord. They don't want to die ever. They want to remain forever. So that means there's contradiction. The Jews, they don't want to die. Allah mentioned that they don't want to die. It's not like a believer, a Muslim sahib with tawheed, who wanna die upon the path of Allah Azza wa Jal. His life is cheap to him when it comes to the way of Allah Azza wa Jal. Jews know they don't wanna go. They don't want. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, how many minutes left from Iqama? Hassan. Okay, barakallahu fi. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قُلْ فَلِمَا يُعَذِّبْكُمْ بِذُنُوبِكُمْ. Then why then does he punish you for your sins? If you are beloved to Allah, why Allah punish you because of your sin? بَلْ أَنْتُمْ بَشَرْ. Nay, you are but human beings. مِمَّنْ خَلَقْ. Of those he has created. You are from the creation of Allah. You are a human being. You are not the children of Allah. And this ayah, Bal antum bashar, may be strengthened that the meaning of the ayah is literally, they say they are the children of Allah. Allah say, nay, Bal antum bashar. You are a human. You are a human. From those he create, يَغْفِرُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah forgives whom he wills and he punishes whom he wills. Allah forgives whom he wills and he punishes whom he wills. Some people misunderstand this ayah. When they hear Allah forgives whom he wills, he punishes whom he wills. They misunderstand. What do they think? How do they misunderstand? When they hear Allah forgives whom he wills, and Allah punishes whom he wills. Some people, they misunderstand. How do they misunderstand? Yes? Some people, when they hear this ayah, يَغْفِرُ لِمَنْ يَشَاءُ وَيُعَذِّبُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Allah forgives whom he wills, and he punishes whom he wills. Some people, they misunderstand that ayah. How do they misunderstand? نعم. Now, عموماً, من المسلمين, some Muslims today, if he hears Allah forgives him, he wills, Allah punishes whom he wills, they misunderstand. The misunderstanding is, they don't understand that Allah punishes because of what the person did it. And Allah forgives because of what the person did it. So they have the expectation to be forgiven without taking the means of forgiveness. They have the expectation not to be punished by while they taking the means of punishment. Therefore, Sheikh Sa'd, what he said. This an understanding, rahimahullah. He said, يغفر لمن يشاء ويعذب من يشاء إذا أتوا بأسباب المغفرة أو أسباب العذاب أو أسباب العذاب. Allah forgives whom he wills, punish whom he wills. The Sheikh said, إذا أتوا بأسباب المغفرة. If they comply with, if they do the causes, the reasons of forgiveness, Allah forgives. If they do the causes of punishment, Allah punishes. Just like the ayah we had last night, Allah yahdi man yasha wa yudhillu man yasha. Allah guides whom he wills, Allah misguides whom he wills. Guides whom he wills, the one who takes the path of guidance. Misguides whom he wills, the one who takes the path of misguidance. These have asbab. Somebody enter Jannah has a reason. That should be known. It's not just a happen. It's not coincidence. You enter Jannah, you enter because of what you earn. أدخلوا الجنة بما كنتم تعملون. Enter paradise because of what you used to do. All the Quran because of what you used to do. تلك الجنة التي نورث من عبادنا من كان تقيا. This is the Jannah. We inherit from our slaves those who have pious. They have righteousness. وينجي الله الذين اتقوا. Allah save from fire those who have taqwa. So if you hear Allah forgives whom he wills, don't forget means who take asbab al-maghfirah, Sheikh Sa'd said. The one who take the means of forgiveness. Going to the masjid is a means of forgiveness. Every step you take is a means of forgiveness. Sadaqah is a means of forgiveness. And the like. There is means of punishment. So sometimes human beings, shaitan deceive us. We're committing crime. We're doing major things. And then the person has the feeling, MashaAllah, he's a friend of Allah. Allah will forgive him. Allah Hakim. Allah is wise, all wise. فَإِنْ زَلَلْتُ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا جَاءَتْكُمُ الْبَيِّنَاتِ فَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَزِيزٌ حَكِيمٌ. After the bayinat became clear to you, then know Allah is Aziz, the Almighty, Hakim, the all wise. What means? He punishes, subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who deserves. Yes, Allah's forgiveness, subhanahu, is there. But the rule is, you will be rewarded only by what you do. This is the rule. وَأَلَّيْسَ لِلْإِنسَانِ إِلَّا مَا سَعَى وَأَنَّ سَعْيَهُ سَوْفَ يُرَى. If the person has this sound aqidah, no doubt he will struggle to do good, he will struggle to avoid bad. Because by that, you'll be rewarded. وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمُ وَبَارِكَ عَلَى نَبِيِّنَا مُحَمَّدٍ